always tell them.
We always tell them.
We come from this land.
We come from this land.
If they don't hear us.
And if they don't hear us.
We shout a little louder.
We shout a little louder.
Everywhere we go.
Everywhere we go.
People always ask us.
People always ask us.
Who we are.
Who we are.
Where do we come from.
Where do we come from.
And if they don't hear us.
And if they don't hear us. One, two, three, Roos!
I'll see you at the finish line!
Sometimes, I'm not gonna lie, sometimes like, running, you know, I'm still doing it, far out. But when I don't run, I don't feel like doing anything. You know, running really disciplines me in a way. You know, like, in season, I'm always, like, a lot more on my game as far as homework. And, I don't know, when I don't run, I just feel, like, kind of lethargic and worthless.
I was just thinking to myself, why do I do this? Why do I run? Why is this so important to me? I think it's just the nature of the sport. You know, I guess what you put in is what you get out. And I like that because it's very tangible and it's very real.
I just want to have a good time, and for me to have a good time is just to relax and enjoy being there with my teammates.
It is a very personal thing that you can challenge yourself in running and do it in a way that where you're not necessarily driven by social comparison.
The history of the programs in that building, and from that the middle 80s till today, you know, 20 years later, every year a new group of runners lives there, and it's infamous now.
To me, the slum is really the anchor of this program. You know, Will does his thing, you know, and people like him, but people really like the slum.
The slum to me is the second home, and you know, there's always, you know, four loving men, sometimes five there, sometimes 20. You know, it's a place where everybody knows your name.
You know, there's always an open door policy here. The door's never locked. People come in, go. I feel like if you're stressed out, you can come here and sit on the porch and pet Frodo and chill, you know. I feel like it's just a pretty sweet place and kind of a unique environment on campus. You generally can see people on the porch, maybe peeing off of it, maybe just sitting and grilling. Usually there's a guitar out there getting strummed or smashed. And so once you've had your porch experience, oh, there's lots of June bugs out there too, usually. So then you step in the foyer and you're immediately assaulted by like stale beer and rancid cat food and that sort of thing. This stench just kind of like lays like a fog around your ankles and you don't really notice it too much until there's like a lot of people down there kind of stirring it up. And so then you come up the stairs, which are red, white, and blue, to kind of get the surge of patriotism as you enter the slum. Then you start to notice the holes in the wall as you ascend the stairs. Then at the top of the stairs is the bathroom. And so then off to your left is the party room. So you'll generally hear like Guns N' Roses as well as like the percussion of people punching the ceiling. And then to the right is the kitchen. And so there's almost always like breaking glass sounds emanating from that area. And there's just, you know, it's pretty much squalor on all sides. There's couch cushions around on the floor and you know, crap on the walls. And I think that's pretty much the slum in a nutshell.